Hello guys, we hit 50 likes on my previous video. I'm very happy, so I did it. This tutorial I explain from start to end how I did this animation. It's my very first tutorial, so it will be not so great, but I did my best for you understand what I did. There is summary. With my tutorial is separated in 5 parts, so modeling, shading, products. We explain how I did this with Redshift, simulation, fracture, Voronoi, on Cinema 4D, dynamic, lighting, rendering scene with Redshift. Then you have simulation smoke made with X particles. And I'm not very sure about this one. I'm very beginner in X particles, so I will give you a description few tutorial if you want to go deeper on X particle smoke simulation. 5 post production, and on this part I will show you some quick tips to make your animation more interesting and dynamic. So let's go modeling part. See, it's very simple modeling. It's just a 2-cylinder, low poly cylinder. Here is my reference picture. Very important to have a reference picture for having realistic results at the end. So for the cap, here's my cap. So what we have on this nice texture. Very simple, you see. So material, it's aluminium, very basic material, basic aluminium material. Then I had bump stains are come from Quixel Megascan, very nice platform for all texture you need. So this is imperfection stains. Very nice for more realistic results. Then we have on displacement max and noise, basic max and noise with very small scale for having this nice relief or nice metal material. And you see I had always ramp. I didn't use it here, but it's nice to have ramp. You can have more control with ramp. Very, very nice control. I suggest you to always add ramp to your material for more control. Okay, that's it for the cap. Now for the bottom part. See, it's a little bit more complex. I will explain you exactly how I did it. So here's my nodal. I will go quickly in Photoshop for show you how I prepare all of this stuff. So we back in Photoshop. So here's my reference image you've seen just before on my fourth screen in Cinema 4D. I just write all my text at the same place and my reference image. Important using same place and having same space between between words for having regular results and realistic visual. Then I add white to my text and black to the background. Why? Because I will export it in PNG, all my stuff in PNG, and white will be seen by camera and black will be didn't seen. It's the same like this little square. It means didn't see by Redshift rendering. It's same principle I will explain you in Restif later. So I export my text, then I export this line for same principle, white see, black didn't see, and in second line, like this one, and the text. So I read the, explore this three layer separately in PNG. And we come back to Redshift for explaining how I did all my nodal with this three PNG. We're back in Redshift. I will explain all nodal for this material. So my basic material aluminium, like on the cap, exactly the same. I change just a little bit color. Then we have some roughness JPEG. You see this nice imperfection I had with bump. Or like a broken material, very interesting looking. So I had this one on Material Blender. It's same principle like layer in Photoshop. So here is my layer color 1 with my material, and my blend color 2 is mask. You remember I say I export my free PNG, black and white. This is for mask. So this is this line, just appear this line because we have a mask. Same for the second line, material aluminium, a little bit different than this line. So this one. And mask for the bottom line, you see. And here is a text with plastic material, black plastic material, very simple. And the mask, white, you see, black, you didn't see. So you see guys, it's very simple. Just try to be serious and methodic how you do it. And for finally, we have this nice displacement on the bump. It's procedural, so max basic max and noise with very, very little scale. You see these little dots. It's about the same than the cap, but much little scale. For a nice contrast between caps and bottom part. Okay guys, so here is a scene for Voronoi fracture. So you see it's very, very slow. I just want to show you the final scene with no texture, just topology and simulation. Then I will do now a little work for show you from the start to end how I did this. So this is a little work. I will show you all elements to tell you how I did this simulation for fracture Voronoi. So here we have this guy, the model we see just before, and I had a solid rigid body for equal down and under collision, and here we have floor plane. So this is the base. Just a basic floor plane with 50 and 50 subdivision surface, and I add a displacer with white color, and a spherical field. You see, it makes nice hole. And what we have next? So, here is the cube. So this is the base for fracture Voronoi. It's a very simple cube. You see, no subdivision, very, very simple. And I add a fracture Voronoi. I just rename it to bottom. So what we have on this fracture Voronoi, you see, it separates the cube with lots of different pieces. And all the pieces will be made with point generator distribution, you see here. It's like mask, more you add point generator, more you have different layers. So that's it for the bottom part, and we have the top part. The top part, you see a second couche. You see the space between, you need to have some space between for nice collision. And for this one, you need to add much more point amount of your point generator, or even nice, very nice destruction detail. But first, I suggest you to do little point amount for the scene, don't be too slow. And I add solid rigid body at the bottom, and so just I forget to say, in four plane you have to add a collision for not be the mess, a collision tag, and the top and bottom part you have solid, you have solid rigid body. Rigid body, and what I said on my rigid body, on dynamic of my both rigid body, I said on collision. Why? Because all simulation will be made when this object will be enter in collision. So I will make a quick start of how it works. So rigid body go down, it's quite slow, go down, and you see all fraction this simulation make when it enter in collision. So I suggest you to add a few point amounts at the start, and when you start to be happy with how it works, you add more points, and you can do your final simulation. See, very, very slow. My computer is not so powerful. Hope your computer is more powerful than mine. You see, it's very nice how it works. Radial destruction from center to outline. And one less detail I do. You see some keyframe here. You see some keyframe here. Why? It's detailing. No detailing. Offset fragment. Offset fragment, I had 0 at the start. And I keyframe here, and when in enter, why I say 0? Because I want the floor will be in just one piece at the start. And when it hits the floor, I animate offset for more space between fragments. Very, very good. I suggest you to add offset fragment when this one hits the floor. More interesting visual. Okay, and what I did some keyframe at the Deo Slur 2 on this one, on my follow position. So at start follow position, I want to be 0 because I want to go down faster because it's very heavy. So it's normal gravity. And when he hits the floor, it's not about the same. So you need to move key when he hits the floor. Exactly when he hits the floor. I add some follow position, so the object will don't move after, because it's heavy, we need some follow position. And you need to play with bounce and friction collision noise parameters. Bounce is like how he bounces when he enter in collider with elements. So little bounce, we don't want to bounce too much. Friction, it's like how he will move in rotation with elements. So we want much friction. We don't want to the object slide like viscous or anything. No, we want much friction. And collision noise, it's how fast and randomly it will be moved, so we need quite small collision noise. So that's it for this simulation. Hope you understand how it works, and I suggest you to play a lot with parameters. And this is my parameters for detailing. Say how topology it's did with all fragments. See, top part is more important than bottom part. The bottom part you will didn't see too much on the final result. Top part is very important. Remember, add more a lot of point generator distribution, and two layer is nice for more than randomness. Now I will explain you. Oh, I did this little fragment going around the scene like this. You see this nice explosion collider to the scene. I will explain you how I do that. So here my top bevel, it's a surface. For having this nice surface with fast simulation, you need to go at the end of your Voronoi fracture simulation, take all your calc layer and say connect object to delay. This will make you a static mesh nice for simulation with fragment. Then when we have this, you need to make a shape around your object. Here I have a cylinder object, so I make a cylinder shape. If you have a spherical object, you make spherical shape. Need to be closer of the object. So when I have my shape, I put in a Voronoi fractured. See? With a lot of fragments. Like we have 500, then I add a tag, like you remember for this one, rigid body. Then if I hit play, what happened? It's nice, but it's not what we want. That's why I add attractor. What will make attractor? It will push apart all of the fragments around the scene. You see, interact with the scene because I have a collider body. It's nice, but we want more randomness to how it explodes. So I add a random. You see, all position of fragment are a little bit different now and rotation. I just play with position for this one. If I play, see this nice explosion, randomness, go around the scene. Then when you're happy with your simulation fragment, you can take all of this one and make as alembic. Make as alembic. And that's what I have here. My Voronoi fracture, I animate it for when the object collide to the floor, we will have this nice explosion appear. So I play with scale on this three keyframe. When you have your alembic, you can copy and paste it on your FunHive scene. And now I will talk about shading and lighting the scene. And first I will talk about this nice material, my ground material. So I did it. Just before, I want to show you to add bevel on your surface. If I don't have bevel, we have this round rocks and we don't want this. We want sharpened edge. So I add top bevel. Because there is not subdivision surface on Voronoi fracture, you need to fake it. You see tessellation. Here we'll add fake subdivision surface and top bevel. We'll add some nice sharpened edge. So it's very important to have this. Now we'll talk about material. This is the material. So this material. So what we have? We have I will put this here. Yeah, so we have two material, one gray and one blue. You see these nice little dots. And I add a mask on my blend color, Maxoid Noise makes a mask with very hard difference of black and white, very sharpened. See, if I move it, we have this. So very important ramp to play around with this. You can do what you want, but with this we have little dots of blue, which is very nice. And then for the roughness, this nice surface, I had maximum noise for the displacement. It's about the same than for the blend color layer mask. And you see very, very little scale, you have this nice surface. So you see with procedural shading, we can have nice, very nice material with nothing. Now we'll talk about lighting. So how is my lighting? I will show you. So you see camera is named view product. I say view product. So we'll be always on this view. And now here is my lighting scene. So two area light came from the light, the left or the right, depends on where you are on the scene, and the dome light. So here's the dome light for global light. My right light, very, very strong light at this nice light line. And we have the top. We have a more global illumination with this. So very basic setup. And you see important having both light on from one side. So you have this nice shadow from the right. Nice contrast. We feel more relief with this lighting setup. Here's my my setup for the scene. So you see number of pass, brute force in range cache, nice for the lights go and do some jump when he hits the surface. You have a more realistic render, and denoise optics. It will remove all the noise of your scene. It's magic thing. Very, very nice. So now I will explain you how I did smoke simulation. So I'm very beginner in X particles, so sorry if it's not very precise. So what we have? We have our X particle system with emitter. On my emitter, I add a circle object. You see. When I play, we have this particle. So, I choose emission pulse. See, if you take rate, we have particle emit every time. We don't want it, we want pulse. So it emits only one time. On the burst rate, I had 100. If you add more, you see you have more dots. But for this kind of simulation, we want only few dots. So 100 is good number. So when I have this pulse, what I want to do, I will add an explosion tag. You go right click, X particle tag, and Xprosia source. Then I add Xprosia FX. You go need particles dynamic Xprosia FX. So here this is what we have. So we have this and we add some X particle gravity for having this nice propagation of smokes around the scene. You can have few turbulence as well for the smoke move a little bit differently. And I suggest you, I didn't have add variation, but you can have some variation to your gravity for more organic simulation, more random things better. When you have all of simulation, you're happy with this, what you have to do, you go on X particle system and you go to utilities and you choose X particle cache. This one will appear, you go here. AX format, you got an open VDB and you chose where you want to save your cache on what folder. So you go on the beginning and you say build cache. When you have finished to export your cache, you will create a Redshift volume. Here, object, Redshift volume. Then you go on path, and you choose your cache, you just export it. It will be two different folder. Be careful to take this one, this folder. More you go on frame, more heavy it is. That's normal because more you will go on time, more particle we have. Okay, and now you go to animation and changing off to simple and say detect frame. It will detect all your frame you have on your simulation. Then to see what you do, you need to choose point. If you say off, you see nothing to see. If you say point, more you add point, yeah, more you have point, precise, more precise is VDB volume. Say 300, it's good for looking what happens. And to see on the redshifts, like this one, you need to your light have contribution scale to 1 for all of them. When you did this, you create a redshift volume material, and on your redshift volume material you have three different channels, scatter, absorption, emission. Only density it's interested for this one. So you go on redshift volume, information is density fuel heat. You will copy density to here. See if I said, if I remove it, we can see anything. If I add density, we can see here. And you play with scatter coefficient. Less is coefficient, less, more transparent is. I think 0.6 is good compromise for this one. So you see it's quite fast, quite nice. And for having just smoke and black, you need to put red points to all of your scene. So after you can export it in PNG and alpha channel. It will export you only smokes, and black will be removed because it's PNG. And it's very nice to do in this way because you can retime and changing opacity of your smokes whenever you want in post-production. And now I will talk a little bit about post-production. So that's the final part. So you see smoke in PNG, you export your PNG sequence smoke and you put when the bottle hits the floor. And that's why it's very important to separate smoke to your bottle, because you can add mask. See, I animate a mask around the bottle for smoke didn't hit, transpire the bottle. And I play with time remap because it was too slow for the animation, so I time remap it a lot. So yeah, you can do what you want with this. Here's my, you see I play with mask. Some parts you don't want to animate or you have some bug, you can play with mask. So what we have to have more interesting and dynamic animation. So I put some motion blur. You see CC motion blur to my bottle with a mask, animated mask. See, much, much more interesting than this. That's fake all the speed from top to bottom. Very nice effect, CC motion blur. And I had a mask, animated mask for just affect the bottle. And we have some radial blur, animates just here for more dynamism. And we have a slider. I will put in description how I did it. This slider make random position shaking camera. See, very nice when it hits, like the all of the scene go messy with this explosion. So quite simple post-production here. And finally, étalonnage by using Lumetri Color. Very nice effect for changing color by using curves. Here, a bit of curve. More, you have more vibrant color with this. And I use a lot of creative. It's, you have many different parameters of what you want. I chose this for because I would like some blue, nice blue tints. I just put 20 intensity, just a little bit. Okay guys, so that's it for this tutorial. Hope you enjoy it and you learned something on what I said. You can follow me on Instagram. I post a lot of on this page, and if you do Voronoi fracture creation, please send me a message.